I just bought the latest generation of the Zenbook Duo, and I want to see if it has the features that I've been asking for. What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter Von Panda here. I bought this laptop, paid full price for it. It's actually the only version of the new generation of Zenbook Duos that is available right now. So I'm not sure why they're so slow to release the other ones, but probably is a situation of them ramping up. But this is a Zenbook Duo, and it's the UX482. I actually showed you, and I did an in-depth review of the UX481 on this channel, and I really loved it. It was a laptop that made me switch out of the Mac ecosystem. It comes in this big box, man. It's not gonna be a super easy thing to unbox. Ooh, look at this. I didn't get this one in my last one. It's like a leather sleeve. So already we're off to good start here, because, all right, it's not leather, it's some sort of like synthetic material, but it almost has like a brushed stainless steel like look and feel to it. It's got the singular direction grain on it, but it's black material with orange stitching right there. There's a magnet right in here, so it'll close right there. Asus logo on the top, and then a microfiber like lining inside, and then also a little pen loop right here too. So hopefully this one will come with that stylus, but that's pretty cool. Again, my MacBooks never came with that. But the thing I loved about that laptop and why it made me switch from the MacBooks was the dual screen Duo, Asus Duo, and it's really a game changer. Now, that laptop also had some trade-offs, and there were a couple of them, most notably, that kind of annoyed me, but the screen was so important to me, and having that extra productivity, especially when you're on the road, when you're using a laptop, to have more of a desk type like experience with a second screen was so valuable that it basically outweighed my concerns with the other things. So you can see right there, Asus Zenbook Duo comes in this blue-ish box right here, but super nice, super premium. Kind of reminds me of an iPhone box, but this blue is actually replicated on the case of the laptop. As far as I know, the Zenbook Duos only come in this one color, celestial blue. Woohoo! There it is, all wrapped in plastic. It's fantastic, even if you don't live in a Barbie world. So, first of all, I want to show you this power adapter right here, because this is actually one of the improvements. So, we get this Asus power plug, and one of the things that's interesting about it is it does not have retractable prongs. As you can see, it's only a couple inches square, so it's kind of like a MacBook adapter. But here is one of my issues, is that the last one, although it had USB-C, which is the sausage looking plug right there, the old one did not have Thunderbolt, so you could not pass power through it. And that was a fairly big disappointment to me, because you had to carry around the Asus proprietary power cable, and in a pinch, you couldn't just adapt a USB-C cord to power up the laptop. So the fact that this now uses that Thunderbolt port to power it is one huge improvement, because everyone has USB-C cables, and especially if you're on the road and you lose your plug, or if you want to buy extra ones to keep in your backpack at your work, this is a much easier standard to find than a proprietary Asus power cable. Now, here is the laptop itself. Before we get to that, I just want to finish unboxing here. Right here, looks like we have another pull tab. And here, oh cool, we get some other stuff. So this is a piece that you can attach and stick to the bottom of your laptop. And it's basically kind of a glorified kickstand. And what it'll do, because the keys are so far forward, you don't have a palm rest, what this'll do, apparently, is just kind of get it up at another angle for you, which is maybe slightly more convenient. So you can see we have sticky pads right there, so it'll attach to the bottom, and then it is kind of hinged. Not totally sure how it works, but I know it'll give you about another inch of lift on the back here. Then, what I'm also excited about is, well, not so excited about this, but we do get a little booklet. But right here, and what was not in my old box, everyone said that they all come with a stylus, but my old one did not have it. It may have been purloined at some point. But you can see we get this little stylus here, a little clicking button right there, and now I can actually draw on the screens with this little bad boy. And especially that second screen, if you are taking some notes, you're trying to illustrate something, the thing I think that this could be really useful for, and is something actually my desktop computer lacks, is when you're doing a Zoom call and you have a document and you just want to show some key things, circle some things, highlight some things, move some things around. If you are in person, it's very easy to just print out something and make notes right on it. But with a stylus like this, it becomes almost that easy that you can do it digitally like you were in person, and you don't have to drag around a mouse and be as clumsy with that as you can with a stylus. So I'm really excited to try that out. That could be a really big game changer for me. All right, now we are finally at the laptop portion. This is the UX482. This is the smallest size. It's basically a 14.1 inch display. They do have a larger one, the UX582, which is a 15 inch display, which I don't have. I do think that that one has a little bit better trackpad because of the larger size, but this one is really the ultra portable of them. And so I think this is the one that's gonna make the most sense. The 15 inch is more of a desktop replacement. Then there's the Zephyrus Duo, which is really a gaming laptop, which is almost a desktop in and of itself. So beautiful celestial blue color on the top. It has a little bit of iridescence in the way it is textured. You can see the Asus logo right there. We have this little sticker here that comes off like this. So I wanna show you here that it says the Thunderbolt 4 right there. So I know we have that. It also says faster Wi-Fi as well as longer battery life and faster CPU boots. And one of the things that I want to do as I just pop it open here is there should be a sticker inside right here that says Intel Evo. Now, Evo used to be referred to as something else. I think they may have shortened it to make it more sticker friendly. But this is actually the only Asus Zenbook Duo that is Evo certified at the moment, as far as I know. And the reason that's important is because this one has at least a balance of components that provides a certain balance of performance and battery life. So this thing should have all day battery life. I think it advertises something like 7 hours. So for most of us, if you get a lunch break in there and you're shutting your computer down between meetings, should be able to go all day on a single battery charge, which means if you're a road warrior, you're working airports, in an airplane seat, on a bus, if you're sitting in meetings a lot of times, you don't have a dedicated workspace, whatever your situation, this should be able to get you through all day, assuming that you charge it at night, which is awesome. I love the idea of an all-day battery life because so many computers now get decent battery life, 2, 3, 4 hours, but that means you will be tapping that power cable at some point, all right? Now, the other thing before I spoil it for you here, the big thing that I didn't like about this is that once you open this up, the second screen, which is right here, and you can see it, it's kind of separated right there, was built into the lower portion of the computer and did not move. And what that did is it put the screen on the same plane as the keyboard, which made it a little hard to use. It wasn't bad, but you were kind of looking over the keyboard a little bit. You were kind of straining a little bit more. Now this one, what you can see here, has a moving second screen. So as I open it up here, what I want to show you is that second screen is now hinged and moves up. Now, it's only maybe 10 degrees or something like that, but as I go ahead and just sit it down right here, it's a really subtle difference, but it does make a difference. Now, it's not perfectly angled towards my eyes, but the example that I would give you to experience this is if you have a flat monitor in front of you and you drag a window over to that side, it's not really angled that far away from you, but it doesn't seem like it's very direct. And a lot of us shift over to read it or maybe twist the monitor a little bit. And that's one of the big advantages of curved monitors. When you move something over there, it tends to be angled a little bit closer to you and it feels much more natural. Now, if you have a really good curved monitor, like a 1000R curved monitor where it's really perpendicular to your face, that's pretty amazing. But even a subtle or slight move towards you actually goes a really long way. So I love the fact now that that sits up. I will show you there, it says Harman Kardon, so you get Harman Kardon sound in there. And the speakers, I believe, are underneath the screen. So it's gonna pump out that sound out the side. The audio on the old UX481 was not bad, but this one I think can even be potentially better. Now, what I will also show you here is that it looks like there are some heat vents out of the top right up here. So maybe it blows up that heat there because I don't see a lot of heat type of vents on the back. I will also say that similar to the old one, when you lift this up, you get this little ledge from the top screen, which lifts the whole laptop body up. But this is kind of a straight edge, and it's all plastic, and it's not necessarily the most comfortable thing to have in your lap. I actually wish that they would put a little rubber strip there. They actually do have a rubber strip here and a rubber strip down here. So when the laptop is closed, it's actually going to sit pretty securely on your desktop. But if they put that up there too, I think it would also prevent it from marring anything, especially if you're moving the laptop around. And also maybe just give you a little added security. If it gets knocked a little bit, it's not going to move. From an aesthetic standpoint, I will tell you that there are a couple things that I really like about this. First of all, I noticed that on the second screen down here, it has a little bit of a matte finish, which is kind of nice because a lot of us have overhead lights, and so it's more pronounced to have reflection on a screen that's flat to your surface as opposed to one that's more vertical. But if you look up here, both of these have a little bit of a matte finish, which I actually really like on laptops. I like it so much that I'll usually get matte screen protectors and put those on afterwards. So I do like the fact that they have that. And when they're built in, they tend to still look sharper to me than a laptop screen with an aftermarket screen protector on it. The other thing that I will say is exactly the same is the keys look exactly the same. You have island style keys here. I never had a problem with them. My only issue with it is because of the way this is set up, the trackpad is over off to the side here. It's about 2/3 the size of a business card. And what that does is it moves the keyboard over. So what you're doing is instead of centering yourself to the screen right here, you're kind of centering yourself right over here. So instead of just sitting in front of the laptop like this, you actually kind of move the laptop over like this a little bit. Now the keyboard is a good size, that's not a problem. But I have found that obviously the trackpad is a different size than the screen. So you do a lot of back and forth horizontally on the screens, and this doesn't give you a lot of real estate. That's why I think in most cases, trackpads are the same shape as a screen so that you can go anywhere on the screen in one swipe. But what I found here is that you do end up having to do two or three swipes to get all the way to the left or right side, as well as there seems to be a little bit of a dead space on the border on this trackpad. So sometimes if you're starting right at the edge, it doesn't register it. So that's something to keep in mind too. So the next thing I have to do here is power this little bad boy up, get it set up, try it out, and see what we think. Okay, so I've been using this Asus Zenbook Duo, the UX482 version, for several days now as my primary computer, and overall, I really love it. It's actually a really good upgrade from the UX481, even though some of the changes are pretty small. So after using it, I do want to explain what I really like about this, but then I actually want to tell you what I think the next generation of this should actually have. So first of all, the only version that's out is the 8 gig RAM, 512 gig hard drive. And that's unfortunate because I would have preferred to go to the 16 gig RAM, 1 terabyte hard drive, but it's not available yet because it's only a $200 premium over this. So I think it's actually a really good value. Now, the problem there is that I don't think it is Intel Evo in that version, but now because this is an Evo, it wakes up one very fast, but then two, it's supposed to also have incredible battery life. And I will say that over 2 days, I tried not to charge it at all. So when I was setting it up, I charged it to a full charge, and then I was actually able to use this as my primary computer for 2 days. Now I probably had 5 hours of runtime on it in the first day, and then in the second day, I probably got about 3/4 of the way through the day and it died. So I would say that in normal type of work, web surfing, document creation, emails, those types of things, even watching some YouTube videos, this thing lasted probably about 9 hours in my testing. And then I did plug it in because I got the low bat warning. The other thing I really love about this is the ports on the side. Now, might not be the easiest thing to see here, but we have USB-C, which are Thunderbolt ports. You also have an HDMI on this side here. But what's great about that is that I charged it up using this RAV Power 65 watt charging brick with a USB-C cable, and it charged it up no problem. So you don't have to have the proprietary Asus charging block. You can buy some of these extra ones, like I said, have in your car, your travel bag, your briefcase, at work. You know, if you go on vacation, you don't have a single cord that might break. Now, on the other side here, we have some other ports, and we have a USB-A, headphone, microphone jack, as well as an SD card. And I just want to show you the hinge here, because this is actually something that's really interesting to me. You can see that it lifts this up
maybe about half an inch, maybe almost three quarters of an inch. It's not quite an inch. And to me, this little change, because the old panel used to stay flat here, is actually really nice. Now I wanna show you here, because if I swing it back to the position that I'm looking at it and I raise the camera right to where my eyes are, it does help a little bit. I don't feel like I'm looking down on it as much as I'm looking at it. Now, if I were to take a video, and the, one of the things that I was doing a lot is kind of putting YouTube down here and then expanding the video up, it does work pretty nicely and it's kind of out of the way. I also was using it to do my taxes, so I had some of the spreadsheets and inventories down here and some of the forms, and then I was moving and copying the information up here. So it's actually really nice from a productivity standpoint. And if I were to use this as a desktop replacement, the two screens make it virtually a desktop replacement, as opposed to something with like my MacBook where it was all one screen and I had to do a split screen, and then you get two skinny windows which aren't that usable. So I really actually like this. Now I will say here that I think this could raise even higher, because what you can see here is that we still have bezel visible on this back screen. So honestly, if you raise this up another half an inch, twice as high, what I think is it would not block, from the way I'm looking at it, any of the screen back here. It would probably get pretty close, but I actually think you could actually tilt it even a little more. Now, what you're gonna have is two different planes. You're gonna have a closer screen and a further screen, but I don't think the difference there would create focus issues for you. The other thing that this does is I think that they put the speakers somewhere back there or underneath here. I can't see them specifically, but I will say when I am playing videos here, playing audio, what's really nice is the audio experience.
What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter from Panda here. I just picked up this. This is basically the newest thing.
It sounds good. It sounds rich. It doesn't sound tinny. It doesn't sound hollow. It just has a good sound for laptops. As good as any of the other laptops I've used. And I think the speakers are underneath this panel. And what I think it's doing here is it's kind of leaking the sound out either through the sides or more specifically out here at the back. And what it's doing is it's kind of reflecting off this main screen and coming back at me. So it actually seems like the sound is coming right out of the screen, which is a cool little feature. So I actually kind of like that. It's pretty clever. And I also certainly like the touchscreen. A lot of people have asked me about this touchscreen up here, certainly touchscreen down here. Also, you can use the pen, but it is kind of nice to have the touchscreen, especially if you're doing some quick touch controls. A couple of my quibbles about the screen is that it seems to have some sort of auto dimming feature. Sometimes when it changes, like you turn out the lights and it kind of goes dim, but it's too dim, it takes a little while for it to come back. You know, not minutes, but it's kind of slow to react, a little slower than I would say my iPhone is, but it's not that bad. Or sometimes when you turn the lights on, it kind of oversaturates as well and then kind of settles back in. So I'm not sure why that is, but I haven't played with the settings too much. Now, the other thing down here is that I have moved the brightness level of the second screen all the way to max brightness, because what I think is maybe because the angle isn't directly at me, but it seems a little bit dimmer, or maybe the finish on the screen is a little bit more matte than the one up here. But to me, to get it to kind of match this top screen, I have to move the brightness slider all the way to the top. Now, the other thing I will show you is on this extra screen, the slider is over here. So by default, it comes over here, and you can change it in the settings here to change the position of it. And I actually like it on this side because I'm right-handed. And so if I want to change this, you can just quickly reach up here and change it without going over here. You can also have it on the bottom there, but I like it on the right side. So for some of you that get this, and if you're right-handed, you might find it better on the right side. I will tell you that this little slider is not that self-explanatory. It's not that intuitive. I wish you could control these a little bit more. To be really honest, the only things I really, really want are things like, you know, the screen flipper and maybe the brightness control and maybe a shortcut to the keypad. And I felt like on the original ScreenPad software, they had that. But to me, it's a little weird because to get the trackpad up, I have to go up here to this number key button and then it's there. And certainly putting over it on the right side is kind of the most normal thing for me. But this trackpad is actually really useful. I wish it had maybe a little haptic feedback or even some sound with it, because as I was typing in numbers while doing my taxes and some spreadsheets and things like that, you don't really know kind of naturally where your fingers are, but you get used to it pretty quickly and the buttons are large enough that it's actually really useful, especially since you don't have that right here like you would on a normal laptop. So this trackpad is actually a huge, huge benefit to me. a lot of the other things about this are exactly the same as my previous review. I don't think physically, like the keyboard has changed, the trackpad is pretty much the same. The screen up here is pretty much the same. I do like the Windows login where it reads your face. I'm not sure how secure that is, but it seems to work kind of like Face ID pretty well. Probably my biggest issue with this is the trackpad. This trackpad is probably one of the worst trackpads. It's not the worst I've ever used because it's nice and smooth and slides well. So some of the really cheap trackpads feel like cheap plastic and your finger doesn't even slide that well on them. So it does work. And in a pinch, if you're just using the laptop standalone, great. What I do have is this Microsoft Arc mouse, which folds up and I can travel with this. But using a mouse with this is so much nicer than using this trackpad. Now, in another version, if I were a product developer for Asus, the thing I would probably change here is I would probably add 2 inches of height to this screen and raise the screen. I wouldn't actually change the panel out, but what that would give me is 2 more inches of bezel down here. Then I could put in a new arm under here that would raise the second screen almost another inch or two, so they'd almost kind of be like a curved panel, and it wouldn't block any of the bottom. So especially as I'm sitting here, and this is where my eyes would be, if I tilted this forward almost so it's vertical, and this were 2 inches higher, it would be in a perfect position, and actually this screen would be lifted up, so it would even feel a little bit more like a desktop. It'd be a little more ergo. I don't think you'd be looking down with your neck. It'd probably help your posture a little bit. But the advantage to that, to me, is that there would be 2 extra inches down here. So when you clamshell this back down, right, if this is going to be 2 inches higher, it's going to be 2 inches longer down here. And then you could turn in this 2-inch area here into a wrist pad and then center a trackpad down here. So you could take this trackpad almost and put it sideways. And I think that that would make this the ultimate laptop. A comfortable palm rest with the ability to control the trackpad with your thumb, because otherwise it's a trackpad. The keyboard would be more centered, right? As opposed to being off-centered by like about 10% here. So you could have a full keyboard, maybe even a keypad, whatever it might be. But then you would have 2 screens that would be more vertical for you. So that would be the enhancement I would make. And yes, it would make the laptop less wide, you know, less of a 4:3 ratio and more of a 1:1 ratio. But to me, that's fine. I don't really care what the size of the laptop or the shape of the laptop is when it's closed. It's just when it's open, is it using the space that it's given in the most efficient way possible? And that would actually make it the ultimate laptop in my opinion. So I really like this Asus Zenbook Duo UX482. I think this configuration right here is really probably maybe even the best configuration for most people, kind of like you and me, that are just average computer users that want good battery life, quick boot up time. You know, to me, even though it only has 8 gigs of RAM, I haven't noticed anything being slow or jittery or anything like that. So I just think for the kind of the middle of the road computing needs, this is overall a really good one. Now, I will say, I thought about, hey, why don't you go up to the UX582, which is a little bigger. It's a 15-inch screen, a little bigger trackpad. And you might say, hey, Pete, isn't that the ideal one? That gives you the big trackpad. Well, I think the problem there is that the ports on the side of the UX582, the larger one, are Thunderbolt 3, and I don't think they allow it to charge. I think the laptop either requires too much power to charge off those ports or something like that, but I don't think it allows you to charge off those ports, which was my gripe with the previous laptop too. I don't mind a proprietary charging cable, but I like being able to charge off the Thunderbolt port in a pin. So if you want to pick up this Asus Zenbook Duo, I really like it. I'll put a link to it in the description below. Peter Von Panda, out.
Power through it. And that was a little bit